PDF documents are a crucial file type for your business or your everyday use. Whether you're using it for contracts and agreements, maybe for marketing materials or newsletters, I'm sure that you are using PDF documents on a daily basis. So in today's video, I want to give you five great reasons for using a PDF editor. Hello everyone, Scott Friesen here at Simpletivity, helping you to get more done and enjoy less stress. And in today's video, I'm using PDF Element by Wondershare. If you would like to learn more and try PDF Element for yourself, you can see the link in the description below. So let's get started with reason number one. And you know what? It's right in the name. You can edit any PDF document. So let's take this one as an example. Let's say I've got a newsletter here, and you know, the only thing I have is the copy from a few years back, and I don't have the original file type, I don't have the Word document, all I have is the old PDF. So what am I gonna do? Well, I'm gonna open it up in my PDF editor, and here I can come in here, I can change the date, let's say, for example, I wanna make that 2020 in this case. Maybe I come down here and I say, oh, we're only gonna have 32 meetings this year, so let's delete that and put 32. You can see that it keeps the same formatting, the same coloring and everything. And maybe I want to get rid of this image because that image is dated as well. Let's go and replace that image really quickly here. I'm going to go up to images. Oh, here we go. Let's replace it with this clock. And boom, it's seamless. There it is. It fits in with my PDF document. So even if you don't have the original file or you can't get the original file from someone else, it is so easy to edit any PDF document. Reason number two why you should consider a PDF editor is that you can convert any PDF to an editable file. So I'm gonna look at this one here as an example here. This one is mostly text-based, but let's say that I need to share this with someone else who's actually gonna do most of the editing on their end. They're the ones who wants to revise this press release, and I don't know if they have a PDF editor, if they have any experience. They would like this in a Word file. Well, if I come over here to convert, you can see I can convert this PDF to a variety of popular file types. I can also convert it just to text or to an image itself, but let's go to Word and let's convert this particular one to Word. Let's say, no, I don't care about saving this one in particular. We just want to convert this one to Word. So I'm just going to say underscore Word copy, just so we know that we can find it. I'm going to hit save, and pretty quick. I mean, this is a pretty short document, so it didn't take very long for it to convert it there. Let's pop over to Word and let's open it up. Let's see how we did. Looks pretty good. Looks pretty good. You may notice a few minor formatting adjustments. The spacing may be slightly different than what you're than what you just saw in the PDF document. But for the most part, the formatting, the layout, etc., is all the same. So now I can send this file to my colleague or to the person I'm working with, and they can go ahead and edit it with a program that they are more comfortable with. In this case, Word. All right. The third reason why you should consider using a PDF editor is from a collaboration standpoint, by the ability to both comment and add notes to a document. So let's say, for example, here I am, and as I'm reviewing this, I want to add some notes for someone that I'm working with. And I say, you know, this picture has got to go. I'm going to click on this little sticky note here. I'm going to click on it here, and I'm going to say, can we use something else here? I'm going to leave a little question mark here. Now anyone can come in here that I give access to, and they can just hover over it and they can see my note, they can change it themselves, or they can provide me with some feedback. I can use this highlighting notion here, and I can just highlight maybe a section over top of it. I'm going to double click on that and say, let's get the yes from the client first. Maybe I want to make sure that we get permission to use a particular name here. So again, anyone can come in here, double click, see my comment. You can collaborate and add comments as you're working with other members of your team. All right, now number four I think is really crucial for working with a PDF editor. And actually it's a big reason why I wish I had started using a PDF editor many, many years ago, much earlier than I ended up doing so. And that is adding customizable and fillable fields. So this time I'm going to go up to form. And here you can see that we can add things such as a text box, a checkbox, radio button, drop down fields, all these types of fields that are fillable. Think of how many times you've been sent a PDF form and how convenient it was that you could actually fill it in. You didn't have to print it off and fill it in by hand. You could just fill it in directly. So in this case, I'm going to use this text field one, for example. And let's say I want them to add their full name at the bottom of this PDF. I'm actually going to come over here to edit and just add the text box itself here at the beginning. So maybe I want them to add their full name. So I'm going to add it there. I can now adjust it. I can drag it up here. There we go, click and drag. I actually like these little crosshairs that they include, so I can line it up exactly. So now, when this person goes to use this particular document, this is going to be a fillable field, right? And you've seen that before. I can just come in here and, oh yeah, my name is Joe Smith. Perfect. I can keep filling out that form. So think of how many things that you use as part of your day-to-day or a part of your business where you're needing someone to fill something in. How convenient it is if they can do so directly within the PDF, something that is essential in any good PDF editor. Now, the fifth and final reason why I think you should consider using a PDF editor has to do with protection. So I'm going to come up here and select the Protect tab. Now, in this case, I could add a password if I wanted to. If I wanted to require a password to open up this particular PDF document, I could also set some other permissions, such as allowing them to print or allowing them to make changes. But in this case, I want to show you something in addition to that, and that is actually blocking out or hiding specific pieces of sensitive information. So let's say, for example, in this particular document, let's say that this BCTFD is the name of a client. And I want to share everything else in this document, but I don't want to share the specifics of the client. Maybe I'm, showing some work to a potential client or something along those lines. So I just want to block out this BCTFD. What I can do is I can come up here, select redaction, and then start highlighting things that I want to redact. But you know what? Many PDF documents are pages and pages in length. I mean, what if this is 50 pages in length? Well, that's just not going to do. So let me delete this redaction here. I'm going to show you a much easier way to do so. In this case, I'm actually going to search for the words that I want to block out. So let me type in BCTFD. I'm going to hit search, and it's going to find occurrences of that everywhere in the document. And remember, if this document was 50 pages long, there might be hundreds of references to this client everywhere. I can either choose them individually here if I want, but I'm going to select this first one, which is going to select them all. You can see that they're now all highlighted. They've all got this little red around them. The last step in this case is I'm going to say confirm or apply this redaction. It's going to give me a warning just to make sure that I want to go and proceed with this. I'm going to hit okay, and now you can see I have blacked out references to this particular customer, this particular string of words. I can now save this PDF, I can send it to that client or to other people, and be sure that they won't see the client name, or maybe I want to hide some financial information, whatever the case may be, you can do that with a PDF editor. So I hope I've given you some good reasons to consider using a PDF editor as a part of your day-to-day. Again, if you would like to use the exact features that I've shared with you today here, you can try them for yourself by using PDF Element. You can find a link to their website in the description below. Thank you so much for watching today's video, and remember, being productive does not need to be difficult. In fact, it's very simple.